بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم. Summer task science 2, and we are going to start the last topic of unit 7, that is atmospheric pressure. What is atmosphere? Air around earth make atmosphere, which contains 78% of nitrogen, 21% oxygen, 0.03% carbon dioxide, in 1% other real gases. Dust particle and raindrops also make some contribution in this. So that is why when it exerts pressure on earth, so it is called atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure is measured by an instrument that is called barometer, and it was invented by Torricelli in 1643. How barometer work, so you will study this in class 9, but up to this level you just know it is important that you just know about that barometer is used to measure atmospheric pressure. On earth, at some places the atmospheric pressure is low and at some places the atmospheric pressure is high. At sea level means like we are now at sea levels, the atmospheric pressure is more. Why? Because from the upper layer of atmosphere down toward earth, more air is there, and that is why more pressure is there. And on the top of the mountain, the air is thinner, that is why atmospheric pressure is low. Have you experienced about this thing? Your air pops when you move higher in the hilly areas. Is the altitude increase? So this thing happen. Why this happen? Because you are moving from the sea level, you are going from down. So inside your body, the atmospheric pressure is high. And when you start moving up, so the atmospheric pressure is less there. And keep in mind that the pressure always move from higher to lower region. Inside your body, the atmospheric pressure is higher, so it start moving outside, and that's why your ears pops. The second example which I will give you here, that is why the climber face breathing problem. The climber face breathing problem, first reason is that on the top of the mountain, the air is thinner. If the air is thinner, so oxygen is less there. That is why they feel breathing problem. But you can also see that the atmospheric pressure difference is there. Inside the body of the climber, the atmospheric pressure is high. But when he go up there, so there the atmospheric pressure is low. And that is why he feel breathing problem. This question can come in your mind that when we are here at sea level, so why don't we feel that atmospheric pressure on our body? Is that much more weight of air is on top of us? So why we are not feeling that? The reason is we are not feeling that because inside our body the atmospheric pressure is high, and outside that is also high. How it is inside our body the atmospheric pressure is high? Because we are taking in and out we are taking in oxygen, we are constantly taking in oxygen, that is why in the atmospheric pressure inside our body and outside that is same. So that is why we cannot feel it. I will ask you a question here that you people think about this. Why air pressure at Peshawar is more than air pressure in Mari? You think about this and try to solve it. Atmospheric pressure is also related to temperature. Those areas having low atmospheric pressure, there the weather will be cold. And the areas having high atmospheric pressure, there the temperature will be high and weather will be sunny. Now you can compare the weather of Peshawar with Mari, so you will easily understand what it means. Application of atmospheric pressure. The first application of atmospheric pressure is sucking through a straw. When we want to suck through a straw, any liquid, water or juice, anything, so what we do, we take a deep breath, and as a result, the volume of our lungs increases. And you know that when the volume increases, as a result, pressure will be decreases. Inside our body, now the pressure is low, while outside on the surface of water, the atmospheric pressure is higher. And keep in mind, as I explained to you people, that the pressure move from higher to low region, high pressure move toward low one. So this high pressure will start moving toward low atmospheric pressure region, and it will also take the juice or water, whatever will be there, with itself, and that is how we can suck through a straw. Second application is filling ink in a syringe. The same way, when we move the piston upward, volume of the syringe increases. When volume will be more, inside the syringe pressure will be low. Outside on the surface of the ink, atmospheric pressure is high, and high atmospheric pressures move toward low atmospheric pressure, so that will start moving toward low atmospheric region, and that is how it will take ink also inside the syringe.